I'm getting ready to make some dinner. I am making a zucchini squash, no, not zucchini, spaghetti squash, sort of pasta dish with tofu ricotta cheese. Should be really delicious. But yeah, so I got my zucchini squash right here, ready to be cut open. I have no idea why, but that was so difficult to do. I basically just smashed it open once it was almost all the way cut. Alright, now I'm gonna take out the seeds. Alright, so now we have these cut up and the seeds are out, and I just put them on a little tray. I'm gonna put a little bit of olive oil with some pepper and garlic powder and oregano. Drizzle that on top of these guys. Can you tell I've done this before? Like, how much olive oil do you put? I don't know. Alright, okay. So, now we're gonna flip them over to cook. I'll, like, try and get the olive oil coated nice and evenly, and then flip it over. I tried to get as much of the seeds and the like stringy stuff out as possible. It's kind of like when you carve a pumpkin, how it's like stringy and it's got seeds. I don't know what I was expecting. I mean, it is squash. So, put that on there. Get rid of some weird stringy stuff. And then I'm going to put it in the oven on 375 for 35 to 45 minutes. And we'll be back. Squash is out of the oven, letting that cool down. Got a block of tofu. I'm gonna add that whatever is left of that olive oil mixture from earlier to the tofu. I'm also going to add this secret blend of herbs and spices. Of it, I think the only thing I really know that is in there is nutritional yeast. And that is the most important part, because we want to put some nutritional yeast in this so that it tastes extra good. And like cheese. This is supposed to be our tofu. Oh, I can't. So, okay. This is supposed to be our tofu ricotta. So we definitely want to put some delicious herbs and spices. Not too much, not too little. Now I'm just going to take my immersion blender and blend that up. So, the immersion blender has done a fine job at making some vegan, delicious tofu ricotta. I am about to prepare the spaghetti squash, but first I actually want to heat up the sauce in the pan. Got the sauce going on the back burner. I just used some, what's it called? Newman's Own. And it's just a plain sauce, pasta sauce. Now I'm going to take these and put the spaghetti in there. It will be delicious. As you can see, what I actually did was I took one half of the squash and put it in the base of this pan. Then I put some of the tomato sauce and some of the tofu ricotta on top. And now I'm going to put the other half in the pan with the rest of the sauce and the rest of the tofu ricotta on top, then puts a little bit more salt and pepper and stuff like that, and it should be ready to go. Yay, the lasagna is finished. I'm gonna grab a big slice and dig right in. So I've got a lot left over that will be going in the fridge. Maybe my husband would like to eat some a little later on. Of course, the kitchen is a total mess, but I am going to eat some coconut milk. No sugar added, mint chocolate chip, or mint chip, ice cream by So Delicious. It still has sugars in it, but it's only apparently 1 gram of sugar per half a cup, but it does have, other carbs in it. It's gonna be delicious. I had a little sneak taste of it earlier. It's very good. Good morning, everyone. I am just watching some Christmas shows. I know, it's kind of early, but I couldn't resist. Also, there's not really anything else good this early on TV. It's pretty much just ads and like infomercials and stuff. So I'm frying up some tofu and with some seasonings. I'm gonna put some chow cheese on top too. It should be really delicious. As you can see, I haven't cleaned the pot from last night, which I need to do, but I will do that. I use the special secret herbs that I got. I think they're called D's Secret Spices or something. I got them from a restaurant in Baltimore called One World Cafe. It's really good, and this is actually what they use to make their tofu scramble, at least at their restaurant. And my mom got it for me because it was so delicious, and just a little bit of salt. But so those are frying up. Lost one. I'm not left-handed, so yeah. So I've got my pumpkin spice coffee. I can turn this off now. Pumpkin spice coffee. I've got a little bit left of some German rock sugar from Tivana. It's made out of beets and also Good Karma flax milk. This is the unsweetened kind. It's really delicious. And I think it actually tastes closest to regular milk than any of the alternative milks that I have tried. Also, I got my delicious breakfast over there. I'm going to drizzle some sriracha sauce on top. One-handedly with my left hand. It's like always... You know what, I'm just going to put it on the side, because if you do too much sriracha, it is like, ruins the whole thing. Well, I mean, it doesn't ruin the whole thing, but your mouth will burn the entire time you're eating it. Alright, so that goes back in the fridge. And let me make this coffee. Alright, everyone, well, I am going to go get ready. Well, I'm getting ready to go shopping and go out for the day. I am gonna get some clothes, some new clothes. My wardrobe is very limited. I just did a complete overhaul of it and got rid of most of my clothes that I don't wear every day or just didn't like and wanted something new. So I'm gonna go shopping now. I have to take these dishes and some old shoes and some pots and pans that I'm gonna donate. So that they can get out of our entryway here. We have a pretty small apartment, so that's definitely not going to help. And then I'm going to go to Mom's, my organic market, and recycle some plastic bags and probably grab some lunch. Well, I already ate lunch. Maybe I'll grab dinner since it'll probably be around 5 or 6 when I'm done. And I was in the middle of doing laundry, but ran out of money on my laundry card, so that will have to wait. It is Sunday morning. I just cooked up some more tofu scramble. I'm going to eat breakfast and probably have it with a big glass of unsweetened flax milk. And today I am going to go to my favorite gluten-free vegan dessert. I guess it's not dessert. It's more like pastry or like cakes kind of restaurant, bakery, yeah. My favorite gluten-free vegan bakery, and pick up a couple things for this week. I think I want to have just some yummy stuff to eat for breakfast in the morning. I gotta go to Mom's, because my organic market, because I didn't go yesterday because it took so long to go shopping. But let me show you the things I got. I put them all in my closet. It looks so good. I just walk in there and I'm like, ah, oh, this is amazing. All right. So, I got a really, really soft white sweater. I got a really nice white t-shirt. This is a short sleeve turtleneck. This I got from H&M last week. It is like a vest, I guess. This I've had for a while. This I got from H&M last week. And then I got like a fake leather skirt and two pairs of work pants, which are really nice. So I am super excited to wear all these clothes. I think they look really good. You'll see them. Well, I showed you before, so a couple of them. Anyway, I'm gonna eat breakfast and then get ready to go. Alright, so I literally just walked in, got back from Mom's. I'm still wearing my coat even. I think I'm gonna go for a little walk, like a little hike. Not like a long hike, just to get outside and get some fresh air. But first I gotta put my groceries away. Let me show you what I got at Mom's. So, I got some. This is gluten-free vegan bread. It is really good. It's egg-free, all that. And it's gluten-free, which is awesome because, yeah, gluten makes me not feel good. I got this deliciousness. I've had it before and basically ate the entire thing. I'm going to try not to eat the entire thing in one sitting this time. Let's see, how much is the serving size? It's actually a quarter of it is one serving size, but it's 360 calories, which, I mean, yeah, if you're not really eating any other desserts or anything, fine, but, you know, a quarter of this is pretty big. I mean, that's pretty big. So, that is delicious. I will eat some of that tonight. I also got some more of my favorite Good Karma flax milk, unsweetened flax milk. I love this stuff because it has omega-3s, and it's only 25 calories. Let's see the other nutrition stuff. 25 calories for one whole cup. It doesn't have a lot of fat. It has some sodium in it, but not that bad. I probably only drink about one or two cups of this a day. Then I got some blueberry jam to go with my gluten-free vegan bread. And finally, just something for myself. I got this Weleda Evening Primrose Revitalizing Body Wash. It looked really good, and I've been trying to just be nicer to myself and just treat myself to nice things like this. So it was a little bit expensive. I think it was like $10.99, which is a lot for a body wash. Usually the body wash is like $3, but I mean, you would spend $10.99 at like, I don't know, Bath and Body Works, or you'd spend a lot more if you went to Lush or something. So I think this is a good in between. So, it's my little mini grocery haul. And now I am going to go, I'm gonna put this all away and then go for a walk. I am at the local dog park. And I already saw a cute dog. I'm just gonna walk for a while, maybe like, I don't know, basically until the sun sets. I'm just gonna walk for a while. It's so beautiful. So nice. Just a beautiful fall afternoon. Of course, this is when I wish I had a dog. Look at that thing. Oh my gosh. Nope. Alright, I am just about finishing my walk. The sun is going down. I saw a brown recluse, and we're going home. I did about 2 laps. Alright, so for dinner we have some delicious homemade avocado rolls, avocado sushi, and also some sriracha with gluten-free soy sauce on the side. So, I just wanted to take a minute to talk about why I'm doing this YouTube channel. I am doing this YouTube channel so that I can hold myself accountable for taking care of myself and for eating healthy and trying to lose weight. You know, after moving in by myself, well, I was with my husband, then he was my boyfriend, but after moving in, you know, after moving out of my parents' house and just starting my life, my adult life, you know, and getting a new job and working at a desk job, working in an office, sitting on my butt all day, I have gained some weight and I want to lose it. You know, I want to feel good. I want to feel healthy. I want to do that by eating healthy food and by moving and really taking care of myself. This whole process has been hard, you know. For a year and a half, almost 2 years now, I've been working to build back up everything that was broken down, from gaining weight, from stress at work, from just stress in life in general. And I am ready. So I wanted to start these vlogs for that. And I also love YouTube. I have always loved watching YouTube videos and makeup tutorials and, you know, vlogs and all that stuff. So I want to be a part of it. I want to just have fun and enjoy it with everybody because it seems awesome. So that's what I'm doing. And I hope you enjoyed. I am going to try and upload this so that it is up and going tomorrow, which is Monday, and I already have next weekend's vlog set up. I do work during the week, so obviously it's going to be a little harder to vlog or do videos over the week, but I'm going to try. And yeah, so thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next week. Bye.